J.Schreck.
James.
You know, we're on the trail of adventure. Where are we at today, James?
We're at Picapo's Trailhead.
And Picapo's Trailhead is in Superior, Arizona. So when you come down the hill, you see this beautiful mountain, right? And there's a great hike here, but it's not for beginners. This would kind of remind me of Siphon Draw. Wouldn't you agree, James?
Yeah, very similar.
So it's a little more difficult, but it's very rewarding. But if you're into maybe a little less stress, we're going to take you all around Superior today and show you what great surprises that this city has in store for you. You ready to go?
Yeah, let's go.
Come on, let's have an adventure today. You know, no trip to Superior would be complete unless you went to the Boyce Thompson Arboretum. Now, a lot of you like me, probably, you stop by, you pass by, and you're like, man, next time I do this, James Wright, I'm gonna stop, and you haven't stopped. Well, take my advice, stop. This place is awesome. This is basically number two on the trip, or on the trail to Superior. You know, when we come over here, one place that we like to park is in this circle. Now, if you'll notice, when we came down that hill, it wide. Now, you can take a right to get you down to the old mill and the wagon tracks, but there's a couple places that are really pretty difficult vehicle-wise that you might make a choice just to go ahead and hike it. Now, we always stop here and take it in. Now, it's pretty quick to get on. If you come with me, now this area we're going to go to is going to get you up to the Indian ruins, and all this stuff is right along this creek bed that would run into the backside of Boyce Thompson, and it's a great trip.
Yep.
Oh, there's a paw print. You know, somebody, you know, we were talking the other day, I've never been mad that I was armed in Arizona. I've never been upset like, dang it, I've got to carry arms. I mean, I don't always do it, but I'm never mad when I do. So, yeah, everybody's got their own comfortability. But this is really a cool place because you'll notice this used to be an old ranch right through here. Now we're in the backside of Pinell City. We just drove through Pinell, and this is just a quick, cool hike.
Oh, God damn it. Somebody's in a vehicle. If you got a truck that you don't really like, this would be great just to drive through.
Now, right here. Now, it wise. This is just a little circle drive, right? Now, this way goes up to the mine, to the cave. Now, but I wanted to go show you something. So we're going to loop over here just because I want to show you something that we found that not everybody's seen. And to me, it was a cool deal. I can't tell you everybody think that way. But there's a well over here, which I found really intriguing. This is a really nice, because you know, out here, it comes down to, you know, having water. Water's critical. That's what made this place so neat. So I just thought this was a cool, really well-built well right here with animals in it. Says those birds or something else.
That was something bigger.
So if you walk right up this path right here, now now, at this location right here, you can do two things. There's a trail right here that will run you up to that road. Now, if you take that road, the Perlite Road, it'll take you up that ridge to the top of the hill, and what you're going to find out is that's where the Apache tiers are. When you get up there, you're going to see two things. You're going to see a gate, and then you're going to see a trail that goes down. If you take the trail down, you will find Apache tiers everywhere because that's the ruins or the tailings of the mine up top. Now, if you take the gate the easier way, it will take you to where those mines are. So you can go either way, but if you go down below and then you try to get up, what is it, James?
It's a little difficult.
I just thought you was going to say it was a bitch. Because if you watch that video up here, you're going to find that out. Now, to the left is one of the Indian ruins. Right there, that inset. So you can follow this trail right up. If you go straight up and around, now these rocks out front, that's where there's also an Indian ruin. Now, and if you go to the right is where that cave that we climbed under the rock. So right here is where the cave is that we climbed underneath the rock. Right here is where there's a rock with a habitat underneath. And then up to the left-hand side is where the ruin is. So you can get to all this stuff right here. Then if you want to climb across, you can go right up that trail and up and over. That's a pretty good hike up that road, though. You can drive it if you have a four-wheel drive vehicle that you do not like. If you hate that truck, James, drive that bitch,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, you better not like it.
Now, what people don't realize though, okay, so there's the truck. You can go this way or you can go back out and go that way. Both these roads come together, right? So you can hike either way. So if you come out of that area, you can go across, you can go that way as well. What people don't realize though is you just drove through a town that had 2,000 people living in it when you went down that road. So there is debris remnants all over this area. This was a huge town, it wasn't small. So if you go back on that road going out and you go find the dump, and they'd have maps in Superior that you can find all these sites, and you should. So let's go to the wagon tracks. So we're at number 6 right now, which is the old mill. And it runs all the way across this mountain right here, over this mound. On the very top is the assay office. To the left was the mill. And it was really a neat place. Now, if you notice this road right here, and you had a vehicle that you wanted to do some off-roading, this is Perlite Road. So this would take you up to the Apache tiers if you wanted to run it. And if you got to here in your vehicle, you could probably go up there. If you've taken the choice like we did to walk it, then you know you're not going to want to go. Now, here's the tricky one. A lot of people want to know where the wagon trail is and the wagon tracks. And that's difficult to find, but we're going to show you. From here, you just walk on down, heading towards back 60 on this road here, which would be the Perlite Road, which actually at one time crossed 60. Now this road here went to the Silver King Mine. So basically the wagon trains would come down this, and we'll show you the loop that they made over here. Now, there used to be a sign down here that somebody regrettably have stolen, and this would have been really easy if that sign would have been up, but it wasn't up when we came down here. So it made it a little more difficult, not terrible, but a little more difficult. So here we are at number 9. That's the easy way to get here. And look what you get. These are absolutely incredible. This is solidified volcanic ash that has been ground down by thousands and thousands of trips with ore wagons. Now, here's another tip we're going to give you that most people don't know, but I'm going to make this easy because nobody made it easy on me and James, did they, James?
No, not quite.
So come with me real quick. Let's go out here. Now, the Pinnell Cemetery is just across the road. Now, how you know where it's at is if you see those power lines over there, that's where it's at. Now, you got to loop all the way around from the backside, and we're going to kind of show you today, but you're really fairly close because remember, when you're in the cemetery, you can see the 60. So it's basically two lefts on that road. Should be closed today because of the forest still being closed, but that's where it's at. So in relevance to the city of Pinnell, it was close. So a lot of people don't get that, but that's the easy way now that we've done it. I understand that that's where it's at. Right over there where those power lines are, the cemetery is basically almost underneath it. Now we're going to go back out the creek way we were talking about to just show you a little something different that most people are never going to get to, but we're going to show you that. On your map, I believe this is number 8. So if you take that wash down, you get to see this, and it's really incredible. You look at the engineering. Now, a lot of this looked natural, but that back wall, they actually laid some type of stone in there and concrete. Now, if you look down there, I mean, it's 60, 70 feet. You wouldn't want to fall in there. But that's really cool. I mean, that's something we wouldn't have found, even though it's listed. It's kind of off the beaten path. Now, this wash will take you back to that main road to be able to hike back. And I'm estimating that's going to be about a 15 to a 20 minute hike. But it's relatively, if the weather was a little better, it wasn't 120 degrees, it would be a little easier, but still not a bad hike.
It's kind of a neat little walk too up this creek, and this is where you start finding all the refuse.
Look at all that, all this
Pinnell City and the years of people being around here. So there's bottles and all sorts of broken glass and ceramics, obviously a mix of modern and old.
Now, one thing that when you're walking through here that I try to take time every time me and James goes out is I really try to get my mind back to what it was like back in those days. And when you look at the amount of wear on that volcanic ash, and you think about the thousands upon thousands of trips that they took down from the Silver King mine. Now also, what's really incredible, and I haven't verified this other than the history I've done, is this was a 20 stamp mill. And it would have sounded like the end of the world. The way that thing, when that they fired that thing up down here, 20 stamp mill is huge. If you want to see what a 10 stamp mill looks like, go to the Superstition Museum right there by Goldfield. They have a 10 mill. So imagine double, and that thing is huge. And it would have just, this would have been so bustling of a city with 2,000 people. And so as we're walking through here, and there's nothing here, I can't help but to go back to those days that this was a bustling town. So I always try to remember what that was like and how big the deal this place really was. Thank you. You know, one thing, James, it took us about 10, 15 minutes to hike back from the wagon tracks, which wasn't very bad at all.
Yeah.
But the one thing a lot of people don't realize is you're going down Main Street when you're taking this, when you're leaving. And just remember that there's remnants and foundations all over this area. So if you wanted to do a little walking around, I mean, there's car parts over there. It looks like a Model A. So there's stuff all over this area. So don't forget, you know, if you wanted to make a day out of just hiking around down here, there's really a lot of stuff to see over here. And if you didn't want to go into Superior, maybe, you know, on farther, shorter day or running out of time, you can still jump across the road and go to the cemetery, which is right there. And we're going to give you a bonus shot also of some stuff to do. You know, if you've got a weekend to spend here, this is just a great place to do it.
Definitely worth spending time in Pinal City, though. You can find a lot of cool things and kind of get a sense of the history back here.
2,000 people is a lot of people, isn't it? It's a big town. Okay, we're getting ready to get back on the highway. But I do want to make sure that everybody understands that if you want to go to the Pinal City Cemetery, it's right across the way. So you go right down that road. And it's that easy. It's, again, remember the key is that you're going to be next to the power lines with those people. Because you go north, but then you loop back south. And remember that you can see the road from there. You know, the first place that you can get fuel is right here, and we always get fuel because one thing that we've learned here is that, you know, you never know where you're going to be, that, you know, on your journey, you know, you may go a few miles more or less, right? So it's always good to make sure you got a full tank of gas, because the last thing you want to do is have trouble when it was self-imposed. You know, a lot of times in these smaller cities too, that the gas is a little cheaper. Today it didn't seem to be, but a lot of times, you know, you can actually get fuel a little cheaper than back in Phoenix.
Welcome to Vivo.
I'm gonna go get me a coffee, James. I'll get me a coffee.
Get yourself coffee. I'll be here.
So here's a real bonus trip. If you want to maybe make a quick trip over to one of the largest open pit mines in the world, then what you'll do is you'll head towards Kearney and Winkleman. So if you run down here on the left-hand side, it's going to take you probably 15, 20 miles, right, somewhere in there.
Yep.
And you'll see on the left-hand side, there's an area that you can actually go, and they're actually still mining here. So if you want to take that as maybe a side road, it's really a pretty cool trip. It's unbelievable how big that mine is. Those trucks that you see that are absolutely huge look like little bitty matchboxes down there. So if you want just a side trip, now, you can also head down there and also run into the Gila River way on down, which is really neat, and then take a left and go loop back around to Globe, which would be a fun trip also. So let's go on up to Atlantis, James.